The recent news drop from 343 reveals new multiplayer maps, some unique customization to Halo Infinite, as well as a close-up look to some weapons and vehicles. That gives us really good insight of how they will play out within Halo Infinite. So stay tuned throughout the whole video to understand all the details. So 343 recently dropped what they call a Canon Fodder, which is a nice little lore-based blog post created by Grim Brother One, and it goes over some really good information about Halo Infinite and providing some context to a lot of things that we just looked at right now when it comes to in-universe style stuff. But it also provides a lot of really cool information about customization and multiplayer and the weapons that we'll see directly in the game. So this is actually much more than just lore. It's actually some gameplay elements we got revealed within this as well. So I wanted to cover that all with you guys as well. So if you guys like these news and informational kind of videos, make sure you tap that like button. Let me know you want to see some more content like this. If you want to stay up to date with everything going on with Halo as they ramp up to the release of Halo Infinite, well, make sure you tap subscribe. So let's get right into the content here. So this first multiplayer map we're going to take a look at is called Live Fire. And the description reads, instructors at the Avery J. Johnson Academy of Military Science ensure their Spartans are prepared for any challenge that a hostile galaxy throws at them. So yes, that Johnson, Sergeant Johnson, is referenced in lore within this training facility. So that is pretty freaking awesome. Next, we have the map Bazaar, which is actually based in Mombasa as well. So that's why it has this kind of urban look to it. I've heard it referred to as Dust 2, but in Halo Infinite, which they wouldn't be too wrong when it comes to this aesthetic as well. Judging by the gameplay that we saw on this map, looks to be another 4v4 arena style map. Next map showcased is the BTB map that we saw. It's called Fragmentation, and an interesting description about this one kind of alludes to something a little bit more evil within this. As the description reads, now more than ever, Installation 07's Serene Service belies a deeper strain and conflict. So that could just be like, hey, you're playing multiplayer, but I'm just kind of reading a little bit more into this as I feel like it ties into a little bit of what they mentioned later in this blog update, which you guys definitely want to stay towards the end for because it's a kind of an interesting point. This next image is the first map that we saw of an image in Halo Infinite. This is called Recharge, and it looks to be another 4v4 style arena map. This map is called Behemoth as well, which kind of gives me like the setting of like the Ark, if you remember from Halo 3, like with the desert look with the old foreground structures in the background. It just seems like that's exactly what it would kind of reference towards. Obviously, it's not going to be on the Ark because it's all on Installation 07. But looking at the image with all the vehicles on this map, it does make it seem like this is another BTB map. But again, we haven't seen enough of this map to really showcase that. But they never really showcased this map in particular when they were showcasing BTB within the trailers and multiplayer overview. So it just makes me think that maybe it's a 4v4 map. I don't know. We'll have to wait until see more. Next, we get some really great shots of Halo Infinite's customization as well. And it just looks so good, guys. Like, this is what I wanted Halo to always look like. Now, interesting thing here, this is the Aviator helmet. If you guys remember, this is a 343 era helmet. And look how they just modified this in, you know, minor ways to really make it fit into the true Halo aesthetic, which I know we're all kind of interested in more of, which is what 343 has been trying to do with this game, is blend their style as well as the classic style together to give you Halo Infinite. Same example here, this is the Soldier helmet, which was originally created during 343's era, but look at how this helmet fits almost perfectly within the art style. Just definitely the best Soldier helmet we've ever had. Now, this Spartan in particular, I really wanted to point out the different levels of customization. Like, yes, we do know we can do robot arms, and we can do a full arm, we can do from the elbow down as well. Same thing with the legs, you can do a full robot leg or just like half leg kind of thing. But interesting thing here is on the visor as well. This helmet right here is the exact same like Mark 7 helmet that we've been seeing throughout all of Halo Infinite's promotional material, but it has a specific attachment on it, and it's called the UA Armament Helmet Attachment, which gives it like a totally different feel. So let's say you really like this kind of visor on your helmet, but you don't really like the helmet style itself. Well, slap your boy on a different attachment right there, and you get that same kind of feel to the helmet, for the visor at least, but then also having the more tried and true Mark 7 helmet. Next, we're going to be taking a look at the weapons and vehicles that were brought up in here, and some really good screenshots, but also some interesting bits of dialogue that they mentioned within this. So especially the Banshee here, saying that this Banshee has been optimized to increase armor and combat durability. So does this allude to this Banshee being a little bit more beefier than your normal Banshee? Because if you remember from Halo Reach, that thing is a total glass cannon where it can deal out a lot of damage, but if as soon as it takes any form of damage, it's taken taken out. I think like 4 sniper shots take it down. So this one might be a little bit more beefier. So hopefully it's a little less agile though, just to kind of compensate for that increased damage. Next, we have a great image of the Brute Chopper, guys. This is like our first like true image of the Brute Chopper and not like something from like Mega Constructs or something. This is just an amazing looking chopper. A great look at the banished ghost. Nothing too crazy happened here. Just looks like a really awesome ghost. Now we had this Razorback here revealed in a previous cannon fodder, but it was just some kind of concept art that was showcased. But now this is like the actual in-game model that we're looking at right here. And some interesting points that they brought up, saying that it has a robust design and up armor design within the description of this vehicle, which makes me think this Warhog-like vehicle is going to be much beefier than the Warhog that we know traditionally. So this thing could probably take a few shots. Like, not a single rocket shot could take this thing down, probably. It'd probably take like 2, maybe even 3. I don't know. They say they can also carry objectives within this, so could you solo cap flags with a Razorback? We'll just have to wait and see. And next we have the Wasp as well, which I wasn't really a big fan of this vehicle within Halo 5, but I think maybe some tweaks can make it really fun to use. Next we have a really high res close up look at the VK-78 Commando. And guys, this weapon just looks so much better than what we saw back at the reveal, guys. It looks like a weapon that was used, picked up, utilized within war. It just looks awesome. I love this design. And next we also have the Skewer as well, which actually we get a little bit of description on what to expect from this weapon, as this is new to Halo Infinite as well. The description reads that the Skewer is an anti-tank spike cannon used by the Banished packs for an anti-personnel task. So like we saw within the trailer, how this Skewer shot that Warhog and just yeeted it off the map. So I'm assuming it would probably see something similar like this for it, much more based off of an anti-vehicle weapon. As I did read the Channels of Reach, and it did mention Skewers being more anti-vehicle, but we saw within the trailer, you can definitely use this against players as well. So maybe this could be the replacement of the Spartan laser, because we haven't seen that at all within Halo Infinite. Now this next section here, guys, it's time for some tin foil hat theory, which I kind of alluded to earlier in this video. It's about the Flood and Halo Infinite. As this cannon fodder really is made to showcase Halo Infinite's customization and multiplayer experience, but then at the end of this, they talk about this reading from a community member here from the book Halo Evolutions, which talks about the reintroduction of the Flood into the Forerunner culture before the original firing of the Halo Array. Now, this seems rather random to place into this cannon fodder. Like, why would you mention the Flood when you're talking about Halo Infinite the whole time? Now, this is me maybe just putting my tinfoil hat on and reading between the lines here, but I mean, I think they're just kind of mentally preparing us for the Flood to return in Halo Infinite. I know I'm taking huge jumps in conclusions here, but again, like, we've been seeing so many little tidbits of like toy leaks and things like that, and different things that allude to possibly the Flood returning as well, like that description of Fragmentation talking about how there's a deeper strain and conflict that lies beneath the surface, which what would be the conflict that lies beneath the surface of all of Halo's conflicts? It's the Flood. Now, I don't expect the Flood to be revealed ever before the release of Halo Infinite, and I don't want that to be revealed before Halo Infinite, but again, it's just like, I just feel like they keep like hinting at us, like, hey, the Flood, the Flood, the Flood. But let me know if I'm being too crazy in the comments. Now, we do have an Inside Infinite being released on Thursday as well, guys, which we'll be covering on this channel. So if you want to stay up to date with everything going on with Halo or miss any content from me recently, check out the videos on the screen right here. Got a link to all my news and informational videos right there. So thank you so much for watching. I greatly appreciate it, and I'll catch you on the next one. Peace out.